Today we're going to be making melted crayon art. Step one of melted crayon art. Gather your materials. 3 crayons to peel, super glue, and a white canvas. And on the table are crayons that are pre-peeled. Step 3. Peel your crayons.
It takes a while.
You can go slower. You're fine. As you can see, all of our pre-melted crayon art, all of our materials, all the crayons, you know, all those lovely crayons we had to peel. Okay. This is why we had crayons pre-peeled, because it would take all of our time for the video, so that's why we had our crayons pre-peeled before we started. Okay. Step 4. Place the super glue and glue the crayons. As he's using the super glue, you can see that he's going to break the crayons for the proper length that he would like to make it a design on the canvas. You want to make sure you use lots of super glue to make sure the crayons don't fall off. When you heat them up with the blow dryer, they have a tendency to, like, the glue will get loose. So you want to make sure you apply your super glue in a nice thick layer on the canvas so they will stay while you're blow drying it. Now, as you can see on this one, I kind of like staggered mine to just, you know, get like a different effect. You can see, like, obviously, like, the lighter colors here would melt a little bit more. So it's going to be interesting to see, like, with his, it's going to be like a nice little mix because he has the light colors and dark colors mixed together. Lots of glue, yes, lots of glue. There's a couple different ways you can do the melted crayon art. I just chose this way because I like the nice rainbow effect, and I like the, I guess you could say, dripping effect. I have also done it before where I kind of like just blow dry crayon and it makes like splatter paint on there, so it's pretty cool this way as well. I like the nice drip effect. You can also add tape on the bottom of the crayon art and make like a design, so when you peel the tape away, it's like the crayon melted around the tape. He's almost done here, so we can get to showing the next couple steps. It doesn't have to be exactly that time. Minimum.
I almost put a whole crayon in. Hey,
that means, I mean, if that's what you want. Your unique design is what counts.
True, true.
Got some nice little background music going on. As he's starting to wrap up the gluing process of his crayons, we are going to go to the next area, and we are going to blow dry the crayons, which makes this nice little melted effect. You would like, I mean, if you can blow dry it the whole time on high heat, but it kind of sprays everywhere. It's a little crazy, so I suggest that You blow dry it on high heat just to get the wax nice and hot. And then once you start to blow dry it on high heat for a little bit, then blow dry it on low heat, and then it will kind of like just start to drip and melt because the wax is already super warm. Once he gets done gluing these crayons, we're going to wait a couple seconds to let that, our super 10 second super glue dry a little bit so the crayons don't slide off when we go to blow dry it. Alright, so this is what it looks like from the start before you melt it. So it looks kind of like staggered, and then this is what it's going to look like at the end. Alright. So we're gonna hold it up, you know, do the crayon drop test here. We're gonna walk over here and get them set up right here in our little makeshift craft area. As you can see, here that he's getting his blow dryer nice and heated up. He has it on high heat to get the wax starting to melt. Kind of running the blow dryer across back and forth just to, you know, like I said, get the wax heated up. Soon we'll start to see an effect of the wax melting. Here. All right, we are starting to see some of the wax starting to melt. The wax drip down and make whatever effect you would like. Got some nice blues, grays, and oranges in there to make a nice little pretty color. We've got some shimmer color in there too, make a nice sparkly effect. Now it's all on personal preference of how long you want to partially melt your crayons. Some people like to melt them a little bit less. Some people like to melt the crayons completely and cover the whole entire canvas. It's all on personal preference. Right now he just kind of has it on the lower heat just to get the little drip effect going on. It's looking pretty cool. I'm really liking the mix of colors. All right, and there's his final product. Each step that he followed, got a little stuck there. Each step, in the process of making melted crayon art, and the end result looks like this.